Abhijit, Om Namah Shivaya twice. Please repeat after me. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. This is guided meditation. In which you just have to listen and follow the meaning of the words. This meditation is an appointment with myself. In my busy daily routine, I hardly get an opportunity to be with myself, to visit myself. I'm so occupied in visiting others, in being with others, and therefore I don't have an opportunity to develop an acquaintance with my own self. Perception of myself, I have an opinion of myself, but there is no opportunity to examine whether the opinion I entertain about myself, is it true or not? I believe that I am a limited person. Very often I find myself helpless, helpless. Because I cannot prevent the happening of what I do not want. And I cannot bring about what I want. I seem to have no control. I am controlled by circumstances. Very often, I do not have very favorable opinion about myself. I am critical of myself. Because I feel that I fail to live up to my own expectations. These are some of the beliefs I am entertaining about myself. And the life that I live is determined by these beliefs about myself. these opinions about myself. But who am I truly? This meditation is to explore what my true nature is. Am I a restless person? Am I a stressed out person? This is an appointment with myself. When all other agenda is set aside, right now, nothing else is important. Here, I am important. And therefore, right now, I let go all the concerns about everything else. Right now, all that matters is myself. I give the world the freedom to be what it is. The people who are close to me in my life, I give them the freedom to be what they are. Whether it be my spouse, or family, or children, or parents, or friends, or relatives, I give them all the freedom to be what they are. I make no demands upon anyone. That they should do something to please me, no such demand. They are free to be what they are. I make no demands upon anyone. I gracefully accept the people in my life as they are. Whether favorable or not favorable, helpful or not helpful, wherever they are. They are all fine as they are. They have the freedom to be what they are. I do not carry in my mind any resentment for anybody. I recognize that people are what they are. Most of the time, they don't have the freedom to be different from what they are. Someone is an angry person, no freedom to be otherwise. Someone is a jealous person, no freedom to be other than what they are. Because everyone is controlled by their nature. And therefore, people don't have the freedom to be other than what they are. Meaning, it is nobody's fault for what they are. That would also mean that some of them are not kind to me. Some of them may be mean to me. Some are loving to me. I bless them all to be what they are. I make no demands upon anyone to be different from what they are. Because they are so created by Ishvara, by the Lord. They are in my life because of my prarabdha, my destiny. They all have something to contribute in my life. And therefore, everything is in order as it is. I have no way of knowing that the situation would be better had it been different. And therefore, I gracefully accept. The people in my life as they are. No demands upon others. No resentment for others. No anger for others. No partiality for others. No cruelty for others. graceful acceptance of others is the way to create a harmony with others. So that they do not disturb my mind. So that I do not empower them to disturb me. I gracefully and willingly, happily accept all the people in my life. I have no resentment or partiality for anyone. I equally wish well for everyone. That gives me the freedom to be myself. And I accept myself also as I am. Without imposing any demands on myself as to how I should be. There is no reason for me to be different from what I am. Because I am also all right as I am. Just as others are all right as they are, so also I am all right as I am. But then I have a very limited being. I have so many shortcomings. I have so many defects. There are blemishes also. How can I accept myself? Regardless of how I am, with all my virtues and limitations, I gracefully accept myself. Meaning, I accept my limitations and shortcomings and defects and blemishes without judging myself. I give myself the freedom to be what I am. I give others the freedom to be what they are. And I also enjoy the freedom to be what I am. In spite of all my limitations and shortcomings, it is a matter of my choice to gracefully accept myself. Without being critical, that I make no demands on myself. I give myself also the freedom to be what I am. Accepting others as they are and accepting myself as I am. When I exercise the freedom of choice, I realize that it is possible to accept myself as I am without being self-critical. Because this is how I am made. Everyone is unique, and I am also unique, with my virtues and limitations. I impose no requirements upon myself. I make no demands on myself. Gracefully accept myself as I am. That is my choice. In spite of the limitations, in spite of the shortcomings, I have the freedom to accept myself as I am. When I accept others as they are, I am at peace with them. When I accept myself as I am at peace with myself. There is peace in graceful acceptance. Then I discover that it is possible to be at peace spite of all shortcomings. It is not necessary to be perfect, to be at peace. It is just necessary to gracefully accept myself without judging myself. Regardless of how others judge me, I have the freedom to accept myself without judgment. Then I am at peace with myself in spite of all my shortcomings. Then I realize that peace is my nature. And when there is peace, there is contentment. I realize that peace and contentment are my nature. I am peace, I am contentment. That is my true nature. Peace is my true nature. Contentment is my true nature. When I am not judgmental, when I am not critical, when I am kind and accepting of myself, then I see that peace and contentment are my nature. That is the appointment with myself. Acquainting myself with myself. Chidananda Shivoham Shivoham Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. My core being is Shiva. Peace, silence, auspiciousness is my core nature. Shanti.